So we are starting a new series. The title of the series is Savitri, Notes and Comments. 1. Life stunned by death. Ashwapati is exploring the cause of life's failure in this world, life's failure in this mortal world, life's failure on earth. Life has entered into matter. There was a call from material objects, from mountains and rivers and oceans, and from winds and the tempest and the volcanoes and the bare new deep valleys and canyons. There was not a fish in the water, or a bird in the sky, or an ant crawling in great discipline on the floor of the earth. Not a blade of grass swayed with the morning breeze. No breathing creature, small or large, was ever present. There were gemstones and minerals and gemstones in their exquisite name. Diamond and ruby and emerald and opal and cobalt and topaz, limonite, sandstone, rhyolite, marl, basalt and hard rock, quartz in shades and shapes, and a variety of lifeless crystals. There were the expressions of the glory in the physical. These were the expressions of the glory in the physical. Proud of the precious name, the divine in the depths of matter, the divine in the depths of matter, the divine in the density of matter, the divine in the thickness of matter. But these material objects, they were locked in their own glory and in their own preciousness. They felt helpless and terribly arrested and imprisoned in limits. They remained ever what they were. They had no scope for experiencing countless abundances of matter itself. The gods in them, the gods in material objects, the gods were tied to the laws of matter, its rigidity and severity, rigidities and severities of matter. They were tied to the laws of matter. These gods fastened in matter, cried to life, cried to release them from the bondage of matter. Life responded. She responded with incredible zeal and verve and hope and expectation. She took that she would bring about a change in the life of this trapped god. She was full of greatness and glory and dynamism. She was full of greatness and glory and dynamism in her own world, the world of life, the life world. She thought that she could do something of sort in the midst of matter too. She thought that she could work out the miracle even in the material circumstance. She stepped into matter, left her glory. She saw a world of bliss. Even here, even in matter, a growing wonder of God, and the vast material circumstance too, there was none here to feel, and this had to be redeemed. She took it upon herself, prompted by her superior self. She took it upon herself, prompted by her superior self. She felt the call of material objects. She felt the call of the God. She responded to the entities of the God. God trapped in them. The magic breath was on its way. Into the bare material world, thinking that there would be a red carpet spread to receive her. The magic breath was on its way into bare material world, thinking that there would be a red carpet spread to receive her. But she was stunned by an unexpected ambiguous presence. She was dazed. There was someone who questioned her, who questioned all. She met her fate. She met her fate. She met her fate, which was never anticipated. Life lost her glory and her gladness, her zest, her smile, her smile. She became mortal in an ignorant mortal world. She is now under the complete sway of death, under the complete sway of death. Death and falsehood, a dark transformation came upon her. A dark transformation came upon her. Looks, a secret will robed itself with a thick nine. A secret will robed itself with a thick nine. Robed itself for a purpose. It offered to the spirit the ordeal of the flame. The secret will offered to the spirit the ordeal of the flame. And then the dreadful muteness fell on her. Abolished was subtle mighty spirit, and slain her boon of child god happiness, and all her glory into littleness turned, and all the sweetness into a maimed desire. To feed death with her worm is your life's doom. So failed was her immortality that she seemed inflicting consciousness on unconscious things. An episode in an eternal death, a myth of being that must forever seem. Such was the evil mystery of her chain. Such was the evil mystery of her chain. What Yogi Ashwapati sees is this fallen life, a world where there is no hope, no joy. He has to discover what the intention of the secret will could be. The secret will we send life to matter. Though there is evil absolute rain, the spirit's radiant truth is always with the yogi. With that truth, he must explore the wickedness that has sprung up in this creation. The wickedness that has sprung up in this creation that he must explore. The why of it, the intention also of the secret will. He sees the black quietude. He sees the black forswearing matter. He sees the desirable obstinacy of matter. But now he recognizes the absolute necessity to change all that. But now he recognizes the absolute necessity to change all that. It is the mind of night working at the material base. That mind of night has got to be transformed into the mind of light. The mind of light that alone can open itself to the superior life, to the I supreme, to Parasya Jyoti. But while Ashwapati moves through the cruel and all-swallowing darkness, he protects his soul, protects his flickering soul between his two hands. His being has ventured into the mindless void. It has plunged to measure its depth. It has felt the curious small futility of creation of material thing. Into the abysmal secrecy he came. There darkness peered from her mattress, grey and dew. But Yogi Ashwapati, she is there in the slumber of the cosmic will, the secret key of nature's chain. He sees in the night the shadowy veil of the eternal himself. In destruction, he feels creation's hasty pain. Surely, the eternal has put on that shadowy veil for a purpose. Yogi Ashwapati sees there, in the slumber of cosmic will, the secret key of nature's chain. He sees the secret will located in his chain. He sees the night, the shadowy veil of the eternal himself. In destruction, he feels creation's hasty pain. Surely the eternal has put on the shadowy veil for a purpose. that must be discovered, that purpose must be discovered. And illusions, occult factory, and in inconscious magic printing have torn the formats of the primal name and shattered were the stereotypes of ignorance. But who took the formats of the name? Formats of the primal night, who told them? But it is he whose unseen finger wrote us divine document. It is he whose unseen finger wrote us divine document. It is he who wrote it in the swift intuitive calligraphy, swift in the speed of light, he had written them. It is he who imposed upon dark atoms diamond script or imperishable, upon dumb man fixed on it a name that is the foundation of eternity, the name that is the foundation of eternity, the name of Vishnu. The infernal gleam has died and the magic building is undone. Night opened and vanished like a gulf of dream. The mystic volume of the Book of Bliss is in preparation. The publisher has come up and it should be out soon. Any moment. It is a moment of jubilation. It is a moment of light and flame. It is eternity's unending moment. Savitri, the epic Savitri, does not have the Book of Bliss. But then Savitri, the epic Savitri itself is the Book of Bliss. The ordeal he suffered of his absolute reign. But then, arousing consciousness in things inner, he imposed upon dark atoms and dumb man the diamond script of the imperishable, inscribed on the dim heart of fallen things, a pagan song of the free infinite, and the name, foundation of eternity, and trace on the awakened certain self. In the ideograph of the ineffable, the lyric of the love that waves through time, and the mystic volume of the Book of Bliss, and the message of the superconscient fire, and a wonder, night opened and vanished like a gulf of dream, Let us scan these lines. The ordeal he suffered of evil's absolute reign. Arousing consciousness and things in earth. I am. He imposed an epist upon I am. Dark atom, spondy, and spirit, spondy, dumb man, spondy. The diamond script of the imperishable, the dying, I am. Unscript, I am. Of the spirit, impel, I am. The irishable, tribrag. The first foot could be the diamond amphibrag, inscribed on the dim horn of fallen thing, inscribed, I am, on the period, dim heart, spotty, a form, I am, lung thing, I am, a pagan song of the free infinite, a pagan song, I am, of the free infinite, spondy, spirit, and the name, an appeal, the foundation, name, and the name, foundation, trachim, of the spirit, eternal, I am, nitty, spirit, and traced, spirit, on the spirit, awake, I am exhale, I am turn self, I am. And the ideographs of the in the fable manifest. Tribrak, Pyrrhic, I am Pyrrhic. The lyric of the love that way through time. I am Pyrrhic, I am, I am, I am. And a mystic volume of the book of bliss manifest. I am Pyrrhic, and I am, I am. And the message of the superconscious fire manifest. Pyrrhic, Pyrrhic, I am, manifest. Night open and vanish like a gulf of dream. Sponti, manifest. Pyrrhic, I am, I am. What a meticulousness, essentially pentametrium, but such variation and modulation, vowels and talim at the service of the speaking voice. It is inspiration that gives the poet's technique and the poetic art. Throughout, the inspiration is super overhead. We cannot say that these lines are mantric. They are not. They are not mantric all through. There are present in them several elements: occult, spiritual, psychic, lyrical, mystical, or inner mental, seristic elements. Thus, the audience he suffered of even absolute rain, human mind, the diamond script of the imperishable occult, a pagan song of the free infinite, lyric spiritual, the lyric of the love that way through time, psychic and a mystic volume of the book of brain, inner mental, mystical, and the message of the superconscious fire, spiritual, illumined mind, night opened and vanished like a gulf of dream, occult, surrealistic. But where is that gulf of dream? Where is that gulf of dream? And how does a gulf of dream vanish? How that the night is going to vanish like a deep hollow or chasm or abyss, a large deep beam. How? But it is gulf a beam or a deep chasm, an abyss. It seems to be more an abyss, plunging into the interminable void, an empty space scooped out that the absent God shows up his infinity of presence. It is the dream of the Creator God. Dream of the Creator God who through his sleep wishes to make it real. That real throwing possibility which would materialize as where it is.